first into the tank is a product designed to inspire young girls to expand their horizons.
Hi, Sharks. My name is Alice Brooks.
And my name is Bettina Chen, and we're from Palo Alto, California. Our company is Roominate, and we are seeking $500,000 in exchange for 5% of our company. Our mission is to empower the next generation of female engineers and innovators.
Sharks, we'd like you to think back to your childhoods. Do you remember your favorite toys? And did any of those toys influence your success today? Barbara, what if instead of making a real estate deal in a board game, you were able to build your own high-rise? And Lori, instead of drawing an idea with a crayon, what if you were able to build a prototype? Imagine how young you would have been when you were issued your first patent. Introducing Roominate, toys to inspire the next generation of innovation.
Roominate is a new and revolutionary wired building system for girls age 6 and up. Let's show you how it works. First, you start by building the structure with 3 stories, balconies, even spiral staircases. And the best part about Roominate is the working circuit. Wire up everything from spinning windmills to merry-go-rounds, even elevators, and make it all light up.
We already have a community of thousands of girls and boys we call Roominators. Our Roominators make amazing creations that we never would have dreamed of making. Everything from the Golden Gate Bridge, to a car wash, even a rocket ship. We also have some special Roominates to pass out to each of you. Our Roominators helped us create some.
Terrific.
So for you, Mark, of course we made you the Mavericks Court with
like
a
that?
Private plane to get you there.
With a private plane,
wow.
Of course.
Wow.
Barbara, our Roominators thought that a swanky Manhattan condo would be perfect for you.
I hope they're cheaper than I pay for them here.
And Mr. Wonderful, we've all heard your ice cream shop story. So our Roominators helped us build you an ice cream shop.
Let's see, Kevin, what does it do?
This is the ice cream store I got fired in, so I'm gonna set this on fire now.
And then Lori, our Roominators helped us make you a QVC set. And all these creations have a circuit in there, so if you press the red button, it will activate it. And Robert, we know you love racing cars, so they helped us make you a racetrack.
Thank you. Can I see one of the packages so I can see how it's packaged?
Oh, cool.
Does the car go around?
You can push it around.
What makes this different from Legos?
So it's all about open-ended play. So we give them inspiration and we give them ideas, but ultimately it's up to the kids to decide what they want to build.
How did you guys come up with this?
Well, I studied mechanical engineering at MIT and Stanford.
And I studied electrical engineering at Caltech and Stanford.
So we got to Stanford, the two of us, and we became friends right away because we were two of the only women there in engineering. Oh. And that got us talking, you know? We realized that our common thread was that we'd both been inspired by things that we'd played with when we were younger. Oh. And for me, it was when I was 8 years old, I asked my dad, can Santa Claus bring me a Barbie this year? And he said no. And instead, I got my own saw. So I built dolls and dollhouses out of wood and nails. And that just started my love of engineering right there.
Did you have a natural interest to build things, or did your dad push you that way?
I think that all kids are open to all different sorts of things. The problem right now for girls is that we're not exposing them to more options. So we're missing out on half of the potential product designers, computer programmers right now. Mm. And it's important for all of us that we can get girls doing these sorts of things.
And what are your sales?
We have $1.7 million in sales to date.
This calendar year?
In just a little more than a year and a half.
So this year, what will you do in sales?
This year, we will do $5 million in sales. Right now, we're already at a million.
Wow.
That's pretty amazing.
By the way, others have tried to do this in this space and failed miserably. So I want to hear how you've got distribution.
So at Toys R Us, we'll be in all 596 stores to start. Radio Shack will be in 1,500 stores. We have deals with Barnes & Noble, Michaels, Nordstrom. We're also expanding to Canada this year.
But let's talk about the breakdown of sales per store. What is your turnaround? How many do you sell?
So we'll be in the stores starting in the fall.
Yeah, you
in
mentioned the fall. These are all
so
orders
haven't
that
gone
are coming.
In yet.
You've sold 1.7 million. Where are you making those
so
sales?
So we're in other online channels. Amazon is a big one for us. Basically, last year we were primarily online. And last year we did 540,000 in sales.
Are you getting any sales for boys though? Because it doesn't.
Yes. Yeah, we do have boys playing with it too.
Is it gender specific? On your opening comments, I thought it was a product targeted to developing young girls.
Yes, we've made it gender specific in that you can start by making a dollhouse, but boys have come to us and boys are playing with it.
What does it sell for?
So we have multiple products. The one that you have in front of you now, that's the studio. That sells for $29.99.
What does it cost you to make?
It costs us $8.75 to make.
What do you sell it to the store for?
So with retailers, it ranges from 1650 to 24.
I'm looking at your sales this year. Let's say 5 million. That means about $1 million will be tied up in inventory. You must have brought on some investors by this point to carry that, right?
Yes. We've taken $850,000 in investment, so we own the rest of it. The valuation was at $6
million. $6 million. I mean, I gotta tell you, you've done something remarkable. The toy industry's brutally competitive. I mean, everybody else has failed. Everybody. But I wonder what the sell-through's going to be. That's gonna be the question.
You really put the whole company on the line then, didn't you? Because if you don't sell through, you're dead.
We'll be paid regardless, and we also have close relationship with our buyers.
Look, congratulations for getting this amount of distribution. But now I have to balance, do I pay because I'm so enamored with the growth potential before I go through one seasonal cycle? So in the toy industry, your whole future is this holiday. So if you don't sell through, you're screwed. So the problem I'm having with your deal is I'm being asked to pay for success before I know with certainty I have it. I'm a pragmatic investor that unfortunately knows everything about toys. Everything.
And everything else.
Absolutely.
You know everything about toys.
I know. So to buy this valuation now, which is extreme stretch for me, I'm not going to do it. I'm out.
Well, I think looking at how much we've grown, for our very first year, we did $174,000 in revenue. Last year, we did $540,000. This year, we're on track for $5 million.
If they sell through.
And the next year, we'll also be expanding internationally. That, conservatively, is $12 to $13
million. Here's what bugs me about this. When you first started your pitch, I lit up. Mm-hmm. A toy for girls. Mm-hmm. And yet, I looked at your little package. There's not the word girl on there. It's just a smiley girl face. But it doesn't say anything about girls. I feel like you weren't loyal to your original position.
Girls see this package, they know it's for them. But you don't need to pander to them and push it down their throat that it's for
girls. No, but why not drive it home and target it right to that sweet spot? Your only point of difference, really, between your product and the rest of the dozens out there is that this is for the little girl. And somehow, you didn't communicate that well. And so it felt disappointing to me. And so for that reason, I'm out.
Guys, you know, growing up in Pittsburgh, my dad did upholstery on cars. If you would have told me I'd have this net worth, I would have laughed at you. Mm-hmm. Now I have kids, including mm-hmm. two daughters, 7 and 10. And now my biggest fear in life after my kids' health is that they don't turn out to be jerks, right? That they don't have a sense of entitlement. So I'm gonna make you an offer, but it's got contingencies.
Okay.
I'm gonna offer you $500,000 for 5%.
Okay.
Right? But the contingencies are that my daughters, Alyssa and Alexis, can come out and spend time with you guys, be part of it. You know, I try to put them in a position where they have good role models. Because of all the things in life I can buy, that's something I can't buy. And that's what I want to be part of. So I'm investing in you.
You guys are great. I believe in the business. But I think Mark made you exactly the offer that you asked for. So I'm out.
You know, instead of Kickstarter, my female entrepreneurs, sometimes they call me the Chickstarter because I've started so many female-based businesses. So I think it's so important that young women today, they think they can do and be anything. So I'd be happy to go in on it with Mark. $500,000 for a 5% equity stake. If Mark is willing to go in on it, you'd get two big sharks. One in the tech space, one in the inventor space, and we'll have this on QVC within 4 months.
Yes, you have a deal.
That's great. Done. Thank you, guys.
Thank you. Smart. You.
Good girl.
Congratulations, guys. Thanks. Thank you.
We're in shock. We feel amazing right now. I mean, we're going to be working with Mark and Lori. It couldn't get better than that. We're so excited.
Mark did it because he's too rich and too nuts and too much in love with his kids. That has nothing to do with business.
Plus, we can make him successful.
And it's
okay,
important.
Okay, guys, a moment of silence for that money that just died.
Absolutely. I'm with you this time.
Oh, my God.
Before you go, don't forget to subscribe to the Shark Tank YouTube channel and click on that notification bell to keep up with everything that's bubbling in the tank.